This is a blotched blue-tongued lizard. Now in Manningham, there's 5 families of lizards, and he's a skink. His scientific name is Taliqua nigrolitea, which means black, yellow, blue-tongued lizard. And can you see him poking at his tongue? He's sensing you. He's tasting the air, searching his environment. He's searching for food. Now he's an omnivorous lizard, which means that he eats fruit, vegetables and meat. There are 2 species of blue-tongued lizard found in Manningham. This is the blotched blue-tongued lizard, and you also find the eastern blue-tongued lizard with all the stripes down their back. Blue-tongued lizards are reptiles. They belong to the class Reptilia. They're covered in scales. They don't sweat. They don't have to wear deodorant. Look at all the blotches and splotches on his back. Kind of looks like army camouflage for disguise in the leaf litter. And the dark colorations on his back are a great heat sink. Dark colors help you to heat up more quickly in the sunshine. Blotched blue-tongued lizards are live bearers. They're viviparous. They usually give birth to 8 to 10 babies. His bright blue tongue he uses as a warning sign to would-be predators. Poking at his tongue, making himself look bigger, scarier, and meaner than he really is. Remember, blotched blue-tongued lizards are harmless to people, and they're really important to protect. He uses his back, kind of like a solar panel, to heat up his body in the sun. Now, that's a big issue for a blue-tongued lizard in Manningham because they often sit in the middle of the roads to heat up, and they get run over by cars. Another pressure to a blue-tongued lizard are our pets. Pet dogs and cats see blue-tongued lizards as easy prey. Don't use snail bait in your garden because poor old blue-tongued lizards eat up the sick and the dying snails and they die as well. Short little legs, they can't run particularly fast. Next time you mow your lawns in your back gardens in Manningham, make sure you don't have a sleepy blue-tongued lizard lying there in the sun because often these lizards fall victim to our lawnmowers. Blue-tongued lizards often get mistaken for snakes in people's back gardens. Blue-tongued lizards have a very important job, an ecological niche. They eat up all the bugs, all the arthropods, worms and slugs in your back garden, but they also eat fungi and wildflowers. And when they eat wildflowers, they poop out the seed and they spread native flowers across our landscape. Slow down in the summertime when lizards are sunbaking. Don't run over our lizards. Create lizard lounges in your back garden or in your school garden for blue-tongued lizards to live in. Create shelter for them away from predators. Just invite a blue-tongued lizard to move on into your back garden and you won't have any pest animals eating up all your veggies in your veggie patch. And remember, your pet dog or your pet cat would see a blue-tongued lizard as a juicy snack. So look after them. We need them. They do a great job for us and they disperse seeds of wildflowers throughout the city of Manningham.